Hi, I'm Susan Arendt, and this is the video supplement for our review of A World of Keflings. You are huge in A World of Keflings. I mean, actually huge. You're a giant, towering over the itty-bitty Keflings once you manage to break free from the giant block of ice that imprisons you at the start of the game. Being so enormous, you're in a great position to help the Keflings improve their standard of living by helping them construct new homes and other buildings. It might sound like they're just trying to take advantage of your hugeness, but the Keflings are really grateful and more than happy to do their fair share of the work. They're just... well, they're not terribly bright. So what they need more than anything is for you to tell them what to do. A World of Keflings is all about building. Get a blueprint, mine the resources to construct it, and then put it together by assembling the pieces in the right configuration. You can mine and refine the resources like wood, rock, and sand yourself, but that kind of busy work is best left to the diminutive Keflings. Teaching them what to do is as easy as picking them up, enjoying their frantic shrieking as you dangle them in your hand, and then placing them on whatever it is you want them to turn their attention to. So, to teach a Kefling to bring wool to the factory, just put them on a sheep, then pick them up and put them on the factory. Done. The more a Kefling does a specific task, the better he gets at it, but if you ever want him to start doing something else, just take off his hat and he's ready to learn some new tricks. Directing the Keflings and following the blueprints is all super easy, and if you forget what your next goal is, just pull the left trigger for a reminder. Your end goal in A World of Keflings is to construct a castle for the Dimbulb King, but before you can, you'll have to build an airship and construct a robot, scare off a dragon, make a perch for an enormous pigeon, build a palace for the lizard prince, and a whole bunch of equally ridiculous tasks. You can take your time getting all of it done, though. There's no threat in A World of Keflings. You're not racing the clock or preventing an invasion or anything like that, so you could take your time getting everything done. I actually wish there was some kind of imminent threat to my little friends. Working through all the blueprints was fun, but once I was finished, I felt kind of aimless. The king tells you that you can keep on building, customizing the kingdoms however you like, but once there was no specific goal to work toward, I didn't have much urge to build anything else. Except cannons, because customizing the cannons and dropping a Kefling into them is way more fun than it should be. Ninjas. Yes, I think ninjas for this one.